Now that was a lot of code again, and so I'm really going to need some tests to make sure I got this right. And rather than write the types of tests that we had before with assert statements, I'm going to introduce a new type of test. And this comes from the standard Python module called Doctest. It stands for documentation test. And the idea is that you can write comments, the sort of comments that go with your class items and with your function items, and then automatically have them run as tests. And the tests look just like something that you would type into the Python interpreter. So the way Doctest knows that you've got a test is you have the three-arrow prompt, and then an expression as input, and then the following lines are the output that comes back from that expression. And it tests to see if what comes back when you run the test is what was expected. So here I've typed in what I've done at an interactive session, what the results should be, and then when I make a change to my program, I can run it again and make sure I haven't messed anything up. For example, at the start here, I just want to test out what are the successors of the start state with both glasses are empty, and when one glass has capacity 4 and the other has capacity 9. In general, there are 6 actions, but here a lot of them end up being the same, because if you pour 0 into 0 either way, or if you empty out either of them, it all comes out the same. And so we only end up with 3 states, and they happen to have these labels, 0, 9, filling Y, 0, 0. We call that emptying Y, but of course emptying 0 gives you 0, so it could have been the no op, but that's just the way the successor function works out. And then 4, 0 is filling X. More interestingly, if you have 3 and 5 and you fill, so this is testing when we aren't exceeding the capacity, and this test is when we do exceed the capacity, we can see they work out to the right numbers. And then we solve a problem, we come up with a solution, and so on. So Doctest is a nice capacity to allow you to write tests this way, and you can sprinkle them throughout your program, and then you can run the test. Just say print doctest.testmod, which stands for test module, and if you give it no arguments, it tests the current module. And when I run this, I get the comforting message that there's a test result that says none of the tests failed, and there were 9 that were attempted. So let's go back and look at this solution. So I'm asking, given glasses of levels 4 and 9, trying to find the goal of 6, and this is the shortest solution possible. Fill Y, pour from Y into X, empty X, do the same, empty X again, fill Y into X again, fill Y, and pour from Y into X, and then we end up with a 6 in Y. And we can solve problems more generally. So here I've defined a function numActions, which says, given an X and Y capacity and a goal, how long does it take to solve the goal, the total number of steps it's going to take. And then I asked here for all values of X and Y less than 10, for all capacities less than 10, and for all goals smaller than the capacity, what's the longest, what's the hardest? Which combination of those takes the most actions? And the answer was, if you're given glasses of size 7 and 9 and asked to pour out 8, that's the hardest problem within that range.